Welcome everyone. In this lecture we are going to see the satellite subsystems. That is, till now we have seen the attitude orbital control subsystems, then we have seen telemetry tracking, command and monitoring subsystems, then power subsystems and communication subsystems. In communication subsystems we have taken a review of some of the things like communication is the primary function of a satellite, and for other subsystems it is all other subsystems are supportive to these systems, and this is the only source of revenue for the satellite. Whenever we are designing the communication subsystems, it is always we are keeping in mind that to maximize the traffic capacity, and during the design of downlink and uplinks we are also considering about the number of factors like the antenna sizes and powers. So but the design of downlink is most critical because of the limited output power and limited antenna sizes. In early satellites were power limited, whereas most of the satellites nowadays will be bandwidth limited. Now we'll see the transponder is the another component which is the part of the communication subsystem. Payloads or transponders, how it will function is from the uplink it will receive the signals, that is input carrier power in the range of 10 to 100 kW, and after the processing it will send the output carrier power having C downlink power is 10 to 100 watt. With the help of this it will provide some power gain of 120 dB and utilizes the bandwidth from 0.5 megahertz to 0.5 gigahertz to 1.5 gigahertz, or we can say 500 megahertz to 1500 megahertz. So this is the band of frequencies used by the transponders or payloads. The repeaters and the transponders is the total bandwidth that we utilized is from 500 megahertz to 1.5 gigahertz is too large to be accommodated by a single amplifier. So that on the other hand we can say no carrier occupies such a wide bandwidth on its own. So the total, hence total repeater bandwidth is split into subbands. That is, for few tens of megahertz will be allocated to each of the band. So each band is amplified by a transponder. The repeater is the equipment at the satellite which will have these transponders. With the uplink frequency antennas it will receive the signal, and repeaters will include some of the transponders and then send back after processing signals through the downlink. So the types of payloads or type of transponders are, there are basically major two types, that is regenerative type of transponders which will have uplink is demodulated and signal remodulated before transmission on downlink. And onboard processing transponders essentially digital in nature, and the uplink is demodulated and data recovered prior to processing. After processing the data is reformatted for transmission on the downlink. So store and forward transponders is one of the example of onboard processing transponders. This is the basic transponder elements which will be there into the transponder, which will have some receiver part. Then it will channelize the signal and then transmit part. In the receiver part we can see here, the initially we have the receive filter which is a band pass filter, then low noise power amplifier, then MUX will be used with some local oscillator frequency, and with the help of this local oscillator frequency signals will be mixed with the input signals, and input multiplexer then given to the transponder. That is, for channel amplifiers different channels are given, and after that it is sent to the high power amplifier and output multiplexer is there and given to the output band pass filter circuit. Then duplexer will be used here, and after that the beam forming network or antenna feed is the given, to which we are providing through this to the downlink antenna. So this is the transmitting part of the system, transponder and channelization portion, and this is the receiving part. Now we'll see this one in detail. Transponders in the signal transmitted from an earth station are received at the satellite by either a zone beam or a spot beam antenna. Zone beams receive signals from transmitters anywhere within the coverage zone, whereas spot beams have limited coverage. The received signal is often taken to two low noise power amplifiers and is recombined at their output to provide redundancy for traffic. Redundancy is provided wherever the failure of a component will cause the loss of a significant part of the communication capacity of the satellite. It means that whenever one of the equipment or one of the component will get failed, that redundant availability of these components will take place of the failure component. This is, we can see, the arrangement of the transponder and redundant component arrangement at the satellite, and frequency plan is given here so that the translation frequency is given with the frequency range from the transmitter and receiver for the 500 megahertz bandwidth. We can see at the transmitter we are transmitting from 3700 to the 4200 frequency megahertz frequency. That is, the 500 megahertz band is subdivided for each and every channel, where by spacing of the frequencies from 36 to 40 megahertz band of frequency will be allocated to each channel. Similarly, at the receiver end, we can see here, this is the receiver, will work on the frequency of 5925 megahertz to 4625 megahertz, whereas each channel will be having the frequency spacing from 36 to 40 megahertz. Initially for the first 1945, and we can see here it is 1985. So they are separated by 36 megahertz or 40 megahertz bandwidth. In this figure we can see the satellite communication subsystem, which will work on the 6x4 gigahertz band. There are some of the input filters, then redundant receiver drivers are given. Here the traveling wave tube antennas, to which these numbers will allocate the channel numbers, and different channels are given to the traveling wave tubes antennas, output multiplexer and output filter, and then send it here through the antennas. We, as already said here, that the 500 megahertz bandwidth is divided into channels often for 36 or 40 megahertz, and each channel is handled by a separate transponder. A transponder consists of a bandpass filter to select the particular channel's frequency band, a down converter to change the frequency from 6 gigahertz at the input to 4 gigahertz at the output, and an output amplifier. The communication system has many corresponders, some of which may be sparse. Typically 12 to 44 active transponders are carried by a high capacity satellite. The transponders are supplied signals from one or more receiver antennas and send their output to a switch matrix that directs each transponder frequency band to appropriate antenna or antenna beam. In large satellites such as Intelsat V, there are 4 to 5 beams to which any transponder can be connected. The switch setting can be controlled from the control earth station to allow reallocation of the transponders between the downlink beams as traffic pattern changes. In the early satellites such as Intelsat 1 and 2, one or two, that is 250 megahertz bandwidth transponders were employed. Later on, for GEO satellites have used up to 44 transponders, each with 36, 54 or 72 megahertz bandwidth. The reason for using narrow bandwidth transponder is to avoid excessive intermodulation when transmitting several carriers simultaneously with non-linear traveling wave tube transmitters. Intermodulation distortion is likely to occur whenever a high power amplifier is driven closely to saturation. When a large number of signals share a non-linear amplifier, many unwanted intermodulation products are generated, and some of which fall within the transponder passband. Usually, the intermodulation products are not intelligible signals, but they do increase the overall noise level, and thus the carrier to noise ratio of the wanted signals at the receiving earth station. Intermodulation distortion occurs whenever traveling wave tube amplifiers are used as वाइड बैंड एम्पलीफायर्स फॉर मोर देन वन सिग्नल्स विच ड्राइव द एम्पलीफायर्स इनटू सैचुरेशन. सिंस मोर देन वन अर्थ स्टेशन ट्रांसमीटर सेंड सिग्नल्स वाया अ सैटेलाइट, वन सोल्यूशन इज टू प्रोवाइड वन ट्रांसपोंडर फॉर ईच अर्थ स्टेशन सिग्नल. In the Intelsat system, this could result in a requirement for as many as 100 transponders per satellite. As a compromise between one transponder per Earth station and one transponder for all Earth stations, 36 MHz has been widely used for transponders bandwidth, with 54 and 72 MHz adopted for some satellites. Many domestic satellites operating in the C-band, that is 6 GHz is the uplink frequency and 4 GHz as the downlink frequency, carries 24 active transponders. The center frequency of the transponders are spaced 40 MHz apart and to allow the guard bands for the 36 MHz filter skirts. With total of 500 MHz bandwidth available, a single polarization satellite can accommodate 12 transponders across the band. When frequency reuse by orthogonal polarization is adopted, 24 transponders can be accommodated in the same 500 MHz bandwidth. Initially it is 12, now because of the orthogonal polarization adopted, this number of transponders will be increased to 24 transponders. We can see here in this diagram, we are utilize the 14 GHz dual polarized in uplink frequency with the uplink antennas, which are spot beam antennas. Then number of receivers are there, and this is input multiplexer. So input multiplexers are located to the channels 1, 2, 5, 6, 7, 12 respectively. For different channels these multiplexers are given, but now we can see here the uplink frequency is 14 GHz and for this it is the 6 GHz and all are dual polarized 6 GHz uplink frequency. And this is a zone beam antenna, this is global beam antenna, different antennas we have used here, and all are connected to the switch matrix. With input multiplexers are again allocated to different channels. Now after that, these will be given to the up converters, or that is traveling wave tube amplifiers, and with the help of this matrix, now any channel can be accommodated to the output antenna with the help of this switch matrix. Whereas the output antennas will be having again dual polarized, but having frequency, we can see here it is 11 GHz and for this one it is 4 GHz. This is a spot beam antenna, this is downlink zone beam antennas, and this is global antenna. So with the help of this switch matrix, any input signal, that is if we have this channel 1, 2, we want to communicate with the global beam antenna, we can also connect them with the help of this switch matrix and the traveling wave tube converters, that is up converters, because we can see here that this will be work for very high frequency 14 GHz, whereas this downlink antennas is working at the 4 GHz. So this will be only possible because of the switch matrix, that we can connect to any of the downlink antenna with the help of the switch matrix with input frequency, with different input frequencies. The switch matrix allows a very large number of variations in connecting the 6 GHz receiver to the 4 GHz transmitter, and also interconnects the 6x4 and 14x11 sections, which provides Intelsat with a great deal of flexibility in setting uplinks through the satellite. When more than one signal shares a transponder using frequency division multiple access, the power amplifier must be run below its maximum output power to maintain linearity and reduce intermodulation. The transmitter output power is reduced below its peak output is known as output backoff. In FDMA systems, 2 to 7 dB of output backoff is typically used, depending on the number of accesses to the transponder and the extent to which the characteristics of the high power amplifier have been linearized. Backoff result in a lower downlink carrier to noise ratio at the earth station with FDMA when multiple accesses to each transponders are required. We notice that the saturated output power is slightly lower with multiple carriers because some output power is converted to intermodulation products. The time division multiple access can be used to increase the output power of transponders by limiting the transponder to a single axis. Most TDMA systems are hybrid, that is FDMA TDMA schemes known as multi-frequency TDMA, in which several TDMA signals share the transponder bandwidth using FDMA. Linearity of the high power amplifier remain an issue for multi-frequency TDMA systems. Here we see the single convergent transponder. In that we can see this, the uplink antenna will be work at the 6 GHz and the transponder will having the different equipments on it, like low noise power amplifier, then this is band pass filter, down converters with connected with the local oscillator with frequency 2225 MHz, then band pass filter 4 GHz we have used here, low noise power amplifier, all are at the 4 GHz and high power amplifier and given to the downlink antenna which will again work at the 4 GHz. So the uplink frequency is 6 GHz and downlink is the 4 GHz and one down converter will be used here. So the output power amplifier is usually a solid state power amplifier unless a very high output power which is greater than 50 watt is reduced. When a traveling wave tube amplifier will be used, this local oscillator is at 2225 MHz to provide the appropriate shift in frequency from the 6 GHz uplink frequency to the 4 GHz downlink frequency, and the band pass filter after the mixer removes unwanted frequencies resulting from the down conversion operation. The attenuator can be controlled via the uplink command system to set the gain of the transponder. The redundancy is provided for the high power amplifier in such transponders by including a spare of TWT or solid state amplifiers that can be switched into circuit if the primary power amplifier fails. The lifetime of high power amplifier is limited and they present the least reliable components in most transponders. Providing a spare part of the high power amplifier in each transponder greatly increases the probability that the satellite will reach the end of its working life with all its transponders still operational. Transponders can also be arranged so that there are spare transponders available in the event of total failure. This arrangement is known as M by N redundancy. And for example, it is common to have 16 or 10 redundancy or even 14 for 10 redundancy. It means that if we require 10 transponders, provide the satellite with 16 transponders or 14 transponders. That is 16 is to 10 we can call it. Thus, 6 or 4 amplifiers are acting as backing amplifiers while 10 are online. The most high power amplifier have bandwidths much larger than the allocated frequency band and so it matters little which signals are passing through them. At KU band, that is ring redundancy is used, we will see this all types of redundancies where it is much more like 2 or 2 for 1 and that is 1 spare for every active unit. Now this is the single transponder where we have used the single down converter. Now this will give us the double convergent transponder, whereas transponder will be used for the KU band frequency with 14 GHz uplink frequency and 11 GHz as the downlink frequency. So this is initially similar to the single convergent transponder, that is having the 14 GHz uplink antenna, low noise power amplifier, band pass filter, down converter, which will converted here. This is the 1 GHz band pass filter, 1 GHz intermediate frequency amplifier, and again the another up converter we have used here, that is 10 GHz with local oscillator working with 10 GHz. This local oscillator is working at 13 GHz local oscillator frequency, and again 1 GHz band pass filter, 11 GHz high power amplifier. So we are converted uplink frequency 14 GHz to 11 GHz by a double conversion. This is downlink converter and this is up converter. So 14 GHz input frequency is converted to 1 GHz down converter, and this is up converter which will convert the 1 GHz input frequency with the help of local oscillator at 10 GHz to the 11 GHz frequency, and this is the downlink frequency given to the antenna. So the only transponders we are using here is for single double conversion transponders we have used. So this, because of this, the high power amplifier we are used here. What we did is initially converted from 14 to 1 GHz and then up convert from 1 GHz to 11 GHz. So that double conversion will be there. So this is simply bent pipe of transponders. Single conversion bent pipe of transponder, and this is the double conversion transponder which is of bent pipe, work at the 14 to 11 GHz band. It is easier here to make filters, amplifiers and equalizers at an intermediate frequency such as 100 MHz than 14 or 11 GHz. So stringent requirements are placed on the satellite filters in transponders, since they must provide good rejection of unwanted frequencies such as intermodulation products and very low amplitude and phase ripple in their passband. Frequently, a filter is followed by an equalizer to smooth out amplitude and phase variations in the passband. Phase variation across the passband produces group delay distortion, which is partially troublesome with wideband FM signals and high-speed PSK signals. A considerable increase in the communication capacity of a satellite is achieved by combining onboard processing with switched beam technology. A switched beam satellite generates a narrow transmit beam for each earth station and then transmits sequentially to each one using time division multiple axis of the signals. The narrow beam has to cover only one earth station, allowing the satellite transmit antenna to have a very high gain compared to a zone coverage antenna. A narrow scanning beam can also be used, or a combination of fixed data storage is required at the satellite since it communicates with only one earth station at a time. The downlink, not uplink, usually limits the capacity of a transponder because of the low transmit power available from the satellite. It is possible to conserve uplink bandwidth by using different modulation techniques on the uplink and downlink by providing a baseband processor on the satellite. A high level modulation such as 16 QAM with 4 bits per symbol can be used on the link between the satellite and the large earth station to improve bandwidth efficiency. This approach has been adopted in the Astrolink and Spaceway that will work on 30 to 20 GHz satellites. Onboard processing may also be used to advantage to switch between the uplink access techniques, that is multi-frequency TDMA, and the downlink access techniques, so that is TDMA technique, so that smaller stations may access each other directly via the satellite. So we have seen here the onboard processing transponder. This may be used to advantage switch between the uplink technique and downlink access techniques, so that smaller station may access each other directly via the satellite. The processors can provide the data storage needed for switched beam systems and also can perform error correction independently on the uplink and downlink. A typical arrangement here can of the communication system for satellite employing onboard processing we can see here. This is multiple beam uplink antenna, receiver, demodulator. This is forward error correction decoder is given here, then baseband processors, and this is onboard processing unit. Then again forward error connection encoder is given, modulator and transmitter. Again this is multiple beam downlink antenna, and this is the controller. In this way, onboard transponder, the process of the signals will take place. So these are the transponders that we have seen. There are two types of transponder, regenerative and onboard processing transponders. There are some of the factors that will affect the transponders, or we can see what are the factors that will affect the design of the payload or design of a transponders. So this is the factors affecting payload design, that will be a design of lifetime of the payloads, then reliability, tracking, telemetry, command systems, vibrations and vacuums, then temperature cycling. There are some of the frequency allocation, RF characteristics, linearity, power, available power from the bus, mass and envelope. Then we can see the orbit, radiation environment. All these are some of the factors that will affect the design of a payload, design of a transponder. So in this we have seen the transponders which will be the used for the communication subsystems. So transponder are the main factor which will act as a prime for the communication subsystems. Thank you.